All right, on today's edition of the Thrivetime Show, we're teaching you three proven moves that you can use to grow your revenue now.
Get ready to enter the Thrivetime Show.
We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, and we'll show you how to get here. We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, now we're here.
From the bottom, now we're on the top, teaching you the systems to get what we got. Colin Dixon's on the hooks, I break down the books. Z's bringing some wisdom and the good looks. As the father of five, that's why I'm alive. So if you see my wife and kids, please tell them hi. It's the C&Z up on your radio. And now 3, 2, 1, here we go.
We started from the bottom, now we here.
Yes, yes, and yes, Thrive Nation, we are in the air everywhere, and today is going to be a super incredible show, a glorious show, a show filled with domestic tranquility, because today's guest has the ability to shoot the three-pointer, and he's a successful franchisee, and he's a great brand developer with OxyFresh. Matt Kline is on the line. Sir, how are you?
I am doing great. Long time no talk. I'm glad to be back with you guys.
Brother, I have heard, and maybe I have, maybe I'm exaggerating in my mind. Maybe I'm overhyping, but I believe OxyFresh is having an incredible month this month. I hear a lot of people are reaching out to want to buy franchises. Am I correct, or am I overhyping the game?
No, you are absolutely correct. You know, I think we're in a very unique situation that our franchise has been able to really thrive in these really, strange times, and our franchise has been able to grow. We booked more jobs last month in the United States than we booked at any previous month in the history of OxyFresh.
Wow. Wow. Matt Klein, come on now.
Woo-hoo.
Oh,
yep.
All right.
It's a win for America.
That's unbelievable right there. Now, folks, what I want to talk about on today's show is that if you want more money, if you want more money, solve more problems. Are you looking to earn more money? If you're looking to earn more money, then you have to solve more problems. So I want to start with you, Matt Kline, okay? People out Yep. there, many people are saying, hey, look, I had a corporate job. I just got laid off. Maybe I just got relocated. Maybe the company's switching to a different state, whatever. And they're reaching out to you to maybe buy an OxyFresh as a way to change careers. They want to own their own business now. Yep. They want to own their own job. But at the end of the day, if you want to grow an OxyFresh, you have to solve more problems. You have to clean more carpets. Let's talk about that for a second. If you're out there, if somebody out there is listening today, and they are thinking about joining the OxyFresh family or learning more, what kind of problems does OxyFresh solve for its customers?
Yeah, so, you know, that's a little bit of a loaded question, but it's a good one, because what we've done is we've essentially created automation around small business, right, in terms of not only customer engagement, being able to answer the phones when the customer needs us, being able to answer questions, give accurate quotes on that unique franchisee's pricing structure, and effectively book jobs for them, right? So if we can take that entire slice of the working day pie off of your plate, where you don't have to basically hire someone to answer the phones or train them on the language of the industry or try to train them on the software, and we take care of all that for you, now you can focus on other things like your employees' development, marketing with the OxyFresh team, right? Being able to really establish your structure within your business so we can be better every single day, right? In terms of just being able to engage with your customer base in a variety of ways through marketing, right? So instead of just saying, hey, here's how we market, go ahead and try it on your own, we're going to effectively step inside of your business with you, and we're going to build your online presence from your website, your Google pages, Facebook. We're going to make them operate at a high level. We're going to push content to them. So again, you can focus on small, very doable tasks like getting reviews for your business, not trying to figure out the structure and the back-end workings of Google, right? So we've essentially put all these things into place, including training for you and your employees ongoing, so that you can focus on three things: employees, customers, and marketing, right? Those are the three things we want you to focus on. All the other stuff we've really tried to put in an automation form to where they just happen for you. You can look at your reporting software. So we try to dumb down the business a little bit so you can focus on the really, really important tasks.
Josh Wilson, obviously our team works with you to help you grow your business.
Yes, sir.
If you didn't have our team, you'd probably spend your days, nights, weekends, whatever, working on websites, launching online ads, hiring a videography team. I mean, you could really, really waste a lot of time there doing those things.
But absolutely.
Because our team has teamed up with you, it's a win-win. Now you have a lot of customers with your company, livingwaterirrigationok.com. But I want to ask you and Matt about three ways that we can all solve more problems for our customers. So way number one I want to discuss. Josh, you could just solve more problems for new customers.
Absolutely.
So you could actually reach out to new customers. How do you typically get new customers in the door over there at Living Water Irrigation? Where do they come from?
Typically for us, it's going to come from most likely Google, either from organic or from our Google ads. Also, local services for Google has been fantastic for us. Facebook ads have worked. And then good old-fashioned word of mouth has gotten us a lot of traction as well. So those three sources are where we're getting our lead generation.
Repeat them one more time here. Three ways. You get one is from Google, you're saying, right? Google?
Yep, Google and the facets of Google. So Google ads, the retargeting, and the Google local services, and then the organic results from our the three pack.
Yep.
Then we're also getting them from Facebook, and we're getting them from word of mouth.
Facebook and word of mouth. Okay. Would you agree there, Matt? I mean, if I buy an OxyFresh today, if I reach out, are you guys going to help me with Google optimization, with optimizing the Google map, Facebook? And do you guys do that or not?
We do, yeah. And so what we've done over the last probably 6 or 7 years is we realized if we just put things in place and said, you know, here's what we want you to do as a franchisee, go ahead and do it. We'd have about half of people doing it and about half of those people doing it really effectively. So what we decided to do is anything we could possibly automate here, we did. And so we have an entire team on the back end that's not only going to work with you on the very, very front end of your business when you start to run it, and we're going to do a competitive analysis in your local markets, population density, income levels of an individual city, and we're going to set up individual, what I call them, like little ponds, right? To where we're going to be able to dominate each little pond of your area and your markets to where we can overall have a huge market share. But they're not going to stop there. They're going to build your pages. They're going to keep all of your other 65 directories like Yahoo and Bing and Merchant Circle up to date, pushing content to them. We're going to have a national search engine optimization program, right? And so there's not going to be a piece of that you know, online marketing that we're trying to guess at. We're going to have very pointed types of tasks that we're going to get done that are going to have actual impact on your bottom line just by being able to be consistently in contact with our marketing teams and your franchise coach who's going to be with you for about 6 months, just getting you to some of your goal points to where you can start to jump off. And eventually you'll be able to do a lot of this on your own. But the beginning, it's very much we're walking down this road together. We're holding hands together. We're hitting our goals together so that we can really start to develop that business and essentially start making you as much money as possible.
Now, folks, again, if you want to increase the amount of money you can make, Andrew, I want to get your take on this here. You have to solve problems. There's three ways to do it. Solve problems for new customers. Andrew, think of one of your clients right now that you're working with. We'll go with somebody who sells aluminum trailers.
Oh.
How many of those customers do you have?
Which one of your clients do you work with, Andrew, that sells aluminum trailers?
Oh, yeah, Tyler Hoblet.
That is great. Yeah, what's the name of his company?
Yeah, so it's called Primo Trailers.
And how does he get new customers? How does he do it?
Yeah, so it's actually pretty cool. It's using the telephone technology.
Oh, wow.
And the Google Sheet technology. It's innovative. Yeah. And so what it is he basically has a massive list of dealerships, trailer dealerships that he wants to put his trailers in. He wants them to buy their trailers because he manufactures aluminum trailers, and he calls all of them every single week.
Wait a minute. His product is really good.
It's great.
Matt, I'm sure you've heard people say the product is so good, it's going to sell itself. Because once you start saying,
I got
this new product, baby, and this thing is hot, and it is so good, it's going to sell itself. Oh, I just bought an OxyFresh. It's going to sell itself. Right, Matt? I'm going to sit around waiting for that phone to ring, baby. Yeah, come on. I'm not going to do anything because I got all the money coming in because I own an OxyFresh. Matt, does that happen?
Does not happen.
He You can't park your van out in the middle of the parking lot. People don't walk up to it and request carpet cleaning.
Well, let me tell you this. I have a.
It's actually true. They will do that. But.
Let me ask you this, Matt. If you play that song, if you just play that song and you want it, is that all you got to do?
Pretty much. You'll be as successful as you want to be.
There you go.
Let me cue this up real quick here. This is actually audio from an OxyFresh franchisee owner. No. This is a Stanley Steamer. Stanley Steamer is your top competitor, right? This is not right. It's a carpet cleaning company. This is a guy who bought a carpet cleaning franchise. We believe we cannot prove it.
Mm-hmm.
He bought a franchise of some carpet cleaning business, and he thought the product was so good it would sell itself. This is audio of him self-reflecting on that moment.
Huh. Like eating a spoonful of Drano. Sure, it'll clean you out. It'll leave you hollow inside.
I mean, okay.
Whoa.
That just goes to show you.
Potent stuff.
Okay, but again, everybody out there, write this down right now. What do you need to do every single week to get new customers? Josh Wilson just said, get a Google review, write content, write 1,000 words of content on your website every single day. I'm just giving you action items. He does 1,000 words of content on your website every day. Get a Google review every day. Get those Facebook ads running every day. And that will produce some word of mouth, but you've got to get those new customers. Don't sit back and say the product is so good it's going to sell itself, because that will not happen. Now, the second way to make more money. Now, notice, folks, I'm not going to say looting businesses is a way to make money, because that is too
resale
soon.
Too soon.
I'm not going to joke about looting in Chicago or Antifa. I'm not going to go there, folks. No, I'm not going to give you that kind of Antifa humor that all the kids are into right now. I don't
category.
Need to rely on current events that are too soon to get
flipping,
that easy
flipping
left.
Stolen products on eBay.
That's right.
Like that's not a good business plan.
Yeah. I'm not. If you're out there and you want to, if socialism is your plan to make more money, for any of the Joe Bidens out there, this show's not. I'm not going to talk about that. I'm talking about practical moves. Okay. Now, step number two, our move number two, way number two to make more money, is you could solve more problems for your existing customers.
Yes, sir.
Now, Matt, this is a controversial idea. You walk into the customer's home. You're there to clean the carpet. And what are all the other ways you could serve that same customer? What are all the services that OxyFresh provides? And I don't want you to talk about your customized poetry reading that you do as a personal thing for customers. I don't want you to get in there and talk about male modeling and all the personal services that you offer directly to your customers because of your talent and skill. I'm just saying, across the system, what are other problems that OxyFresh can solve for the customers?
Yeah, I think that's important, right? So if you're there, like at a customer's home, they ask you to come clean their carpets, right? Obviously, you're going to do that and you're going to do the best of your ability. But you also do things like upholstery cleaning, spot treating kits, hard surface COVID-19 cleaners, right, that we have now, carpet sanitizing products, tile and grout cleaning, hardwood floor cleaning, right, in terms of complete odor on hard surface. If you don't let them know what your actual business is capable of, they're not going to go any further than just getting their carpets cleaned, right? If you notice that they have 5 couches that are sitting there and they look like they've never been cleaned, they got hair all over them because they got a bunch of dogs, and you never say that we do upholstery, you're never going to get that job. But that might increase your ticket item by $300, right, just by having a conversation. You might rebook an entirely different job because you realize they have an entire floor of tile and grout.
This story's hot.
Right?
That might
increase by $800 if it's big enough.
Come
right?
on now.
So it's just giving your customers the knowledge to where you could potentially make that job larger. But just think about it. If you don't tell them that you also do tile and grout, and the next time they need tile and grout, come to you, you just lost an entire customer. That other customer, by the way, might also do carpet and upholstery. And if that customer says, oh, we're here to do tile and grout, but we'll also do carpet, you might have lost that customer forever.
And the thing is, if you lose your customer forever, it's like Armageddon. Andrew, it's like just a complete...
pretty bad.
Think about how stupid that is to go into somebody's home to clean their carpet, and then to not say, hey, while we're here, we can do these other services. Think about that. I mean, so what you do is you have to make a checklist of all of the things you can do to provide solutions for the customer. Because you want to make more money, you got to solve more problems. Again, way number one, you solve problems for new customers. You go get new customers. Way number two, to make more money, you solve more problems for existing customers. Now, way number three, and I'm sorry to disappoint AOC, we don't increase taxes. That's not a move. What we do, move number three, and I'm not going to rely on that relevant humor. I'm not going to do that, Andrew. I'm not going to. I'll only read half of your cue cards. Okay, so point number three. We're going to create an upserve checklist of the things that the customers want, but they that you don't provide now. Like it's, you ask them, hey, for, just for future reference, is there any other services? And with OxyFresh, it's a franchise, so it's a little, you can't be quite as flexible because you're buying the system, which is already learning for you. But for like living water irrigation, you started asking your customers, what else do you want, do you need after we do the irrigation system?
Yes, sir.
And people started saying, hey, we would like custom audio,
yep,
custom lighting. I mean, is that correct? I mean,
that is absolutely correct. And so we went with the feedback that we got, and we went with the what the market was saying, and we knew that there wasn't anybody really doing it well here. So now we do audio and lighting.
You know, one of the OxyFresh franchise owners, Matt, I don't know if I can share this story, so I'm just going to do it. He went in the
that
home.
That was a tremendous pause to find permission.
Yeah, he went in the home and he says, hey, I'm here to clean carpets. What else can I do? I think his name was Jonathan Barnett, the founder. What else can I do? And I think somebody might have told him or somebody, tile and grout. Right, Matt? And all of a sudden, you started doing tile and grout. Yep. And you kept adding people. Can you just list off all the things you guys can do right now? Because it's truly impressive at this point. It's not just carpets. You really are bringing a next level yep. clean to the whole home.
Yeah, so we do carpet and upholstery, obviously.
Yeah.
We do tile and grout cleaning.
Yep.
We do hardwood floor cleaning. We do upholstery cleaning. We have a complete odor program where we can go into like apartment units or any unit, actually. We can spray down hard surface walls and you can literally see nicotine pour out of them. We can also do that in vehicles. We have a hard surface sanitizing product that actually gets rid of COVID-19. That's an EPA certified product. And also as of about 2 months now, we have an EPA carpet cleaning sanitizing product that may not seem like a lot, but it is the only product in the industry that actually sanitizes carpet. And then we also have the ability within the next few months, we're going to be able to add a secondary franchise brand here that's going to also do chimney sweeping, air duct cleaning, and also dryer vent cleaning. So that'll be another entire service brand with all the back end office workings, all the scheduling center capabilities, all the technology platforms. So our goal here is to keep expanding our franchise to allow our franchisees more income streams because they've already learned how to run this business. Now it's just stacking on more potential.
Matt, I want to see if I'm getting this idea, and if I'm off base a little bit, Andrew, my life coach, can help me just kind of steer the
I'm
ship here.
Here.
I just want to make sure you guys will clean carpets. Correct, Matt? You clean out the carpets.
We will.
You're going to clean out the chimneys, right?
Well, we will eventually clean up the chimneys. We're about a month and a half.
Month
away
and a half away, Ooh. And then will you be doing? I hate to ask, but I have to. Colon cleansing.
We're going to hold off question. On the colon cleansing for a little bit.
Oh, you guys like
great opportunity you're missing out on.
Matt, I really think that you're missing the whole point of this show. Like, I really
sir,
I think
vertical
you're missing.
Integration. Vertical integration you're missing
sir,
out on.
Sir, real quick, sir. We got the carpet, right? We got the carpet. I got my checklist here. I got the grout.
What other services?
I got the grout. No, you got the chimney. Yeah, you got the. Sir.
The chimney.
We offer what we call the total clean out.
We get it all.
It's going to involve you drinking some weird juices.
And then we need some alone time.
Which I happen to have with me. Let me get my juices. Hey, Matt, you've been married for a while now, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. Full 2.5 weeks.
Have you have you got to a place in the relationship?
Oh, my gosh.
Please don't.
Where is this going?
Please don't. Please don't, Clay.
Listen. I only ask because I care. And you get to a certain point in a relationship.
What does that mean?
Listen, at a certain point, one spouse will come home and say, you know, I think as a couple we should do a cleanse. Have you gotten to a cleanse phase?
I haven't gotten to that.
Oh, you will.
No.
I think our next progression might be a juice cleanse to a colon cleanse, but we haven't quite made that jump yet.
Okay, that's a jump.
Now remind me not to follow up about that.
You don't
remind me.
If it happens, I'll follow up with you.
Okay, with that being said, folks, listen, if you want a franchise that can help you clean your carpets, help you clean your chimney, and it's not going to help you cleanse your colon, check out OxyFresh. They do not help you clean out your colon. They leave that up to you. They eliminate the middleman. They say, you just do that yourself. But go to thrivetimeshow.com/OxyFresh, thrivetimeshow.com, to learn how to buy an OxyFresh franchise. If you're looking for a new career, take your career in another gear. Take it to another level. Check it out. That's thrivetimeshow.com/OxyFresh. Matt, quickly as we go, how much money does it cost to get into the OxyFresh game? How much money are we talking about?
Yep. So you want to be able to invest $39,900 up front to OxyFresh. That'll include your equipment, product, territory, and training. And then you want to have access to about $20,000 to $25,000 in operating capital once you've done that. So a total investment of around $60,000 to $65,000 will get you where you need to be with this franchise. We'll get you up and going, and you'll be running your own business very quickly.
And folks, I don't know, Andrew, I'm not sure if our listeners know what they typically say, but at OxyFresh, one thing they always say is they say,
you know what they say,
we don't clench your colon.
That's right. It's like a slogan.
Like, it's kind of the way you guys end meetings. It's like, yeah. Hey,
you know what they say,
we don't clench colons.
It's just a reminder, just to make sure we don't fall back, drift back into that industry.
Matt, I'll be updating you about the operations manual. When you were out with the wedding thing, JB and I sat down and updated it, and that's our new slogan.
There's a new chapter in there.
It's our new slogan. Matt, I appreciate you so much. Congratulations on your new marriage. And if things don't work out, I'm always your plan B.
All right. I like it.
All right. See you, man. Take care.
All right, guys.
And now, without any further ado,